So in this image, you see the formation of the fold mountains. So Earth's crust gets uplifted and gets folded due to lateral compression and then forms an elevated surface known as the fold mountain. Next type of mountains is block mountains. So when two places on the Earth's crust, that is inner surfaces of the Earth, gets diverged or pulled apart, that means they divide into two parts. Then what happens? Fractures appear on the Earth's surface, right? Fractures appear on the Earth's surface if two parts are pulled apart. And then these fractures are known as the faults. So when two places, Earth's crust, inner surfaces of the Earth are pulled apart, there appears fractures on the surface of the Earth. These fractures are known as the faults. So when these fractures or faults are formed beside each other, then what happens? Then larger areas of the land gets displaced vertically, right? So this land between the fault lines or the fracture lines, the land between these fracture lines either subsides, that is falls, or rises, gets uplifted. So that uplifted part of the land is known as the hot land or the block mountain. So in this image you see land has been separated, pulled apart, and then the faults have either gone inside, that is fallen in, and some parts have been uplifted. Uplifted parts are known as the block mountains, and this is the faults. Next, let's learn about volcanic mountains. From the earth, a liquid part known as magma will be escaping on the surface through a hole, which is known as the vent. Mountains, so those are only known as the volcanic mountains or volcanoes. It hardens on cooling. It forms mountain-like structures known as volcanic mountains or volcanoes. So that liquid part which comes out from the vent and inside the earth or magma is known as lava generally. So that liquid part which reaches the surface of the earth is known as the lava. So this lava, it flows over the surface of the earth, and when it cools down, it hardens. So when it is flowing, it is liquid in consistency, but when it is cooled down, it hardens and forms something known as lava sheets. And then these lava sheets are deposited one above the each other. So continuous there is flow of magma or lava from the inside of the earth through the vent. And when these harden, they form the lava sheets. Such lava sheets deposit one above the each other. And when they reach a great height, they form something called volcanic mountains. And what are the examples of such mountains? So example of such mountains in the world are Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa and Mount Fuji in Japan. These are the volcanic mountains. In this image, students, you see Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa. This is formed as a result of volcanic eruptions or lava sheets. So this is a volcanic mountain in Africa. Let's now study about the importance of mountains. So mountains influence the climate of the land. In any place there are mountains. So we can say that mountains are useful. We can say that mountains are the storehouse of water. And you know, many rivers start their formation right from the mountains only, because mountains have many rivers. And rivers have their source in the glaciers. So glaciers means a hardened ice rivers, right? So hardened ice rivers are known as the glaciers. And when these melt, they form rivers, they form water. And so that is the reason mountains are the big storehouses of water. And the water which flows from these mountains, that water will be stored in the form of reservoirs. Reservoirs are nothing but very big tank-like things where water will be stored. People of the place living around them. So this water will be used by the people. In addition to this, the water which is flowing from the mountains, it acts as an irrigation for the fields, for the cultivation of crops. So this is the source of water supply for the cultivation of crops and also for the generation of electricity. And from the mountains, since the water is flowing, the river valleys and the terraces, these are ideal for cultivation of the crops. And mountains also have a large variety of flora and fauna. Flora and fauna means plants and animals. And forests are also source of fuel. So in this image, students, you can see glacier. Glacier are nothing but ice caps. Over the mountains, the water is present frozen state, that is known as ice. So ice rivers will be flowing here above the mountains. So this is known as the glaciers. Later this melt and form water. And in this image, you can see mountains have a great variety of flora and fauna, that is a great variety of plants as well as the animals. That means a greater variety of plants as well as the animals. Next topic. Plateaus. So what? But plateaus are broad, that means wide, and they are leveled elevated areas of land. So these are also elevated areas, but not as elevated as those of mountains. So a plateau has a flat top and sharp sides. So the top part will be flat and the sides will be sharp. And that is why it is also known as a tableland. Plateau has or more sides and it also has very steep slopes, that is very pointed sharp slopes. And what is the height of the plateau? Sometimes it extends from 100 meters up to several thousands of meters. Plateaus, similarly like mountains, they may be very young or they may be very old. That means they have formed even long time back or even recently. An example of the oldest plateau in India is Deccan Plateau. And talking about the whole world, the African continent has most number of plateaus. Plateaus are always rich in the mineral deposits, iron ore or any other mineral. So these are rich in mineral deposits. So because they are rich in mineral deposits, so major mining areas in the world are located at plateau. We know that the African continent has most number of plateaus. So Africa is famous for gold and diamond mining because Africa has more number of plateaus. And talking about India, in the Chota Nagpur, we have iron, coal and manganese reserves in this plateaus. So the plateaus of Chota Nagpur have iron, coal and manganese reserves in them. Because in the mountains and plateaus, water falls from a greater height. This gives us the image of waterfalls. So since water comes from a great height, many waterfalls are there in the plateau areas. What are the examples of such waterfalls in India? In the Chota Nagpur area, we have Hundru waterfalls. On the river Subarnekha, right? In the Chota Nagpur area, we have Hundru waterfalls. In the river, on the bank side of the river Subarnarekha. And we have also Jog waterfalls in Karnataka. These are the examples of waterfalls of the plateau. And lava plateau formed with the result of magma or lava coming out from a vent. These plateaus are rich in the black soil, and black soil is very beneficial for the agriculture and cultivation of crops. These are such beautiful areas. They are scenic spots. In this image you can see the Deccan Plateau of India, which is a very big. So talking about plains, now plains are nothing but large stretches of flat land. So if a flat land stretches, it is known as the plain. And above the sea level, they are not more than 200 meters high. So they are not at a very much greater height when compared to plateaus and mountains. They are at a less height only just 200 meters above the sea level. So some plains are almost at a very low level and some are also rolling plains and undulating plains. How are plains formed? Plains are formed by the rivers and the tributaries, that means paths of the rivers. When rivers are flowing over the mountains, over the rocks, due to continuous flow of the water, the upper surfaces of these rocks and mountains will be eroded like corrosion. As a result of this erosion and corrosion of these rocks and mountains, these result in the formation of plains. Because of continuous flow of water, rocks and mountains are being eroded, right? So then what happens to this eroded material? The rivers which are flowing, they carry forward this eroded material. And then where does this eroded material get deposited? They deposit the load consisting of stones, sand and silt. So when a river is flowing, it corrodes the mountain surface, sea surface, and then it carries small parts of stones, sand, mud, etc. And in the process of flowing it further in a far away places, these rivers deposit these materials. So what are these places? These places are known as valleys. So it is from these deposits the plains are formed. That is sand, silt and stone. They finally go and get deposited at one specific place. At that specific place only plains are formed. And plains are very fertile, suitable for cultivation. Because they are at a lower surface, that is at the level of land, flat surface, they are very beneficial for cultivation. And construction of transport network over these plains is also very easy because they are at a ground level. So plains are regarded as the thickly populated regions of our world. So talking about the complete world, there are more number of large plains formed by the rivers in Asian continent as well as the North American continent. So talking about India, Ganga and the Brahmaputra river result in formation of plains in India. And in China, in Asia, we have Yangtze river in China, which helps in formation of plains. So since these are flat elevated areas, they are also beneficial for human being habitation. That is, even human beings construct their homes on these plains. So the area where plains are there, definitely human beings concentrate more on that area because more number of flat land is available for building houses, for agriculture, cultivation of crops, etc. So that is why plains are very much beneficial. And since we know that plains are very much fertile, because plains are very much fertile, lot of cultivation happens around the plains. And because good cultivation is there, the yield or the produce is also very high. And since we said that Indo-Gangetic plains are present in India, and these are the mostly populated, densely populated region in our country. So in this image, students, in this green color, you are able to see the plains of India. That is the Indo-Gangetic plain. This is the Malabar plain. In this image, you see these are the northern Sarkars. This is the Indo-Gangetic plain, this part. And this coastal area is Coromandel plains. And this area near the Kerala is known as the Malabar plains. Let's talk about the landforms and the people. So now we have studied about different type of landforms, that is mountains, plateaus and plains. So how people are favoring these landforms, let's see. So people are living in all type of landforms, in mountains as well as the plains. But settlement of people is more in the plains area because they are elevated flat surfaces. Transportation is easy and living life over there is easy when compared to the mountain areas. Because mountains are at a greater height, going to school, traveling, getting groceries, all this is a little difficult in mountains when compared to the plains. So settlement of people is more in the plains. So in addition to that, plains are very fertile where cultivation can be done, crops can be grown. So that is the reason plains are very much choosed over the mountains and the plateaus. So plains provide better conditions for the living. Because plains are on the land level only, they provide a good source for building excellent roads and railway networks also. So in this image, students, you can see a fertile plain land.